मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी स्टडी सम इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक्स ऑफ लेसन थर्ड ह्यूमन रिप्रोडक्शन क्लास 12 बायोलॉजी। टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट द सम मेल एसेसरी ड्रग्स एज वेल एज सम मेल एसेसरी ग्लैंड्स एंड गैमेटोजेनेसिस इंक्लूडिंग स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस ओजेनेसिस एज वेल एज द इवेंट्स इन द मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल इन ह्यूमन फीमेल्स। So let us we go through one by one. As you know that the male reproductive system consisting of the testes. Testes are the primary or important sex organs in the human males. The human males consisting of some accessory ducts, that is rete testes, vasa efferentia, epididymis and vasa deferens. These are the accessory ducts which help in the process of reproduction. As well as the male accessory glands, they include the seminal vesicles, prostate glands and bulbourethra glands. They secrete the seminal plasma. This is a very important question. Seminal plasma, which is rich in the fructose and calcium and certain enzymes. So seminal plasma is secreted by these glands. So it is very important, the role of seminal plasma is the important in the process of reproduction. Now let us we go through the gametogenesis. Gametogenesis means formation of gametes. So formation of gamete takes place in males. It is known as spermatogenesis, that is formation of sperms, and in females it is known as oogenesis. So let us we go through first of all spermatogenesis. The spermatogonia are formed inside the sporogenous tissue in the human testes. So these are the spermatogonia consisting of diploid number of chromosomes, that is they consisting of 46 number of chromosomes. Now mitotic division takes place here and primary spermatocytes are formed. After mitotic division, we can say that spermatogonia undergo mitotic division and they form the primary spermatocyte. They also consisting of 46 number of chromosomes, that is diploid number of chromosomes. Now the first meiosis or first meiotic division takes place in the primary spermatocyte and secondary spermatocytes are formed and it consisting of 23 number of chromosomes. Now secondary spermatocyte undergoes second meiosis or second meiotic division. Now haploid spermatids are formed and these haploid spermatids undergo spermatozoa. They form the spermatozoa. We can say that spermatozoa splits from the spermatids. Spermatozoa means sperms. They are the haploid sperm. They also consisting of 23 number of chromosomes. Here FSH and LH hormones are responsible in the process of spermatogenesis. Now testosterones and androgens also participate in the process of spermatogenesis. Now oogenesis. Oogenesis takes place inside the ovary. The spermatogonous tissue of ovary consisting of the oogonia. These oogonia having the 46 number of chromosomes. This is the fetal life. Whenever the female fetus remains in fetal conditions, so inside the mother's womb, whenever the female fetus consisting of the oogonia and these oogonia undergoes the mitotic division, then primary oocytes are formed after the first mitotic division. This is the fetal life up to here. Now at the time of birth of childhood, that the secondary primary oocytes are formed at the time of birth. यानी कि birth तक बच्चे के अंदर primary oocytes रहते हैं. And these primary oocytes undergo first meiosis or first meiotic division. Then they form the secondary oocytes. यानी कि we can say that at the time of puberty, secondary oocytes are formed. From birth up to puberty, है ना? The primary oocytes get converted into secondary oocytes. And these secondary oocytes undergoes the formation of ovum. three polar body are formed, which are degenerated after some time, and only single ovum is formed. This process is known as oogenesis. That is, we can say that the oogonia and primary oocytes, na, oogonia are formed inside the fetal life. Primary oocytes are formed in the child of birth, at the time of child birth. Then, at the time of puberty, secondary oocytes are formed at the time of puberty, and in adult reproductive life, the ovum is produced. We can say that after the menarche, whenever the first menstruation takes place in human females, they release the ovum, and this process is known as adult reproductive life. So this is about spermatogenesis and oogenesis. Now we go through the very important topic, events in menstruation, menstrual cycle. A most important question, either of 3 marks or 5 mark question have been asked into board examination. So here, this is the pituitary hormone level. This is ovarian events. Ovary mein kya kya events hote hain during menstruation. This is the ovarian hormones and this is the uterine events. So 4 kind of events takes place. Parallel chalti hain sab ek saath. First of all, follicular stimulating hormone level, जो कि pituitary secrete होता है, थोड़ा starting में ज़्यादा होता है, फिर धीरे-धीरे ये कम होता है, and starting में luteinizing hormone level थोड़ा कम होता है, and at the time of the 14 days में होता है ovulation, these are the developing follicles. Ovary में क्या-क्या events चलते हैं? Developing follicles means at the time of menstrual phase, this is first to fifth day, यानी कि 1 से 5 days का जो एक phase होता है, this is the menstrual phase. Now, this menstrual phase में क्या होता है? Developing follicle, यानी follicles, जो follicular cells होते हैं, develop होते हैं inside the ovary. Then, estrogen and progesterone are also released from the ovary, and this is the developed follicle, है ना? They develop follicle. After the 14 days undergoes the ovulation, यानी कि ovulation are emerged from the follicular cells. Only one ovum is released. And this remaining part of the follicle get converted into corpus luteum. Now this corpus luteum functioning as the endocrine gland here. And they secrete estrogen and progesterone here. Now after the 16 or 18 or 19 days, this corpus luteum get degenerated and the next cycle get start from the 28 days. So we can say that this is the cyclic change in the human females, which repeated after every month, hence called menstrual cycle or monthly cycle. So here, these are the uterine events. The uterine cells are less developed. Here, at the time of 14 days, they are more developed, because they are prepared itself for the implantation. But in the absence of the fertilization, these cells are degenerated, and along with the ruptured part of the follicles, that is corpus luteum, as well as ruptured ovum, comes from the body in the form of blood. This is known as bleeding stage. And this is known as menstrual phase. This repeat again after 28 days, hence it is called menstrual cycle. So menstrual cycle, we can say that this is the very important phenomenon in the case of human females. And just at the time of 14 days, the level of luteinizing hormone is high. This is known as LH surge. This is also one mark question. इसमें कितने question बनते हैं? तो corpus luteum, what is corpus luteum? How it is formed? Corpus luteum formed after the degenerated follicles from which the ovum is emerged out, and this corpus luteum functioning as the endocrine gland here. So this is all about these 2 to 3 topics. Thank you and have a nice day.